Now, how to assign a state? We have assigned only letters. It is A, B, C, D, and E. Now we are going to assign its binary value. Now, how to select a binary value? It will be dependent on how many states are there. Now, in order to make our state machine useful in the world of digital electronics, we are going to assign a binary value. Why? If there are two states, that is S1 and S2, so we can assign 0 and 1. If there are four states, then we are going to assign 00, 01, 10, and 11. Likewise, this binary assignment. Right? But if there are five states, then how to assign the binary values? So for five states, it is like 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 110, and 111. That is a binary representation of 0 to 7. But we are only concerned about, as we have only 5 states, so we will move up to 101. Okay? We are not concerned about 110 and 111, that is 6 and 7. Alright? So over here, as it is the 5 states, so we are assigning the binary value like this. Like 000. 001. Alright? Why? Because in these 5 states, the 3 states out of this 8 are unused. Which one? As we have discussed, that my F and G, that we are not going to use. But for binary representation, if you are going to represent the 5 states, so we are assigning a 3-bit, and for 3-bit, the maximum we can reach up to 7. So binary representation of 7 is 111. Alright? For why? Because for 8, its binary representation becomes 1000. So it requires a 4 binary bits. Okay? But as it has a 5 states, so we are only assigning the state which maximum have a bits of 3. Alright? So these unused states that we are not going to be concerned by designing a digital circuit. So we will assign bits with the help of 3 bits. Alright? Why? When we are going to assign the state in terms of binary, then we can say that a table becomes a transition table. Otherwise, we are called it as a state table. If it is represented like this letter, then for this particular state of letter A, if the input is equals to 0, my next state is A. And for input is equals to 1, my next state is B. But if you are going to assign with the help of its binary values, then that table is known as a transition table. Okay? To distinguish it from the state table. Alright? State table means we are assigning letters, that is like A, B, C, D, E, F. And for transition table, we are assigning its binary value. So this is to distinguish the state and transition table. Right? Now we are assigning the binary values. As I have told you, for state A, we are assigning the value, binary value is 000. For state B, it is 001. State C, 010. State D, 011. And state E is 100. Why it is up to 4? Because we have started from 0. So 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So total 5 states are there. Alright? So based on the input, and as we have done in the state table, for the present state A, B, C, D, E, my next state is like A or B or C or D or E or F. So based on the state that we have assigned, we are simply assigned its binary value. And if it is A, then we are simply placing 0, 0, 0. If it is B, then we are simply placing the 0, 0, 1. Likewise, this is my transition table in which all the letters, all the alphabetic letters are going to be replaced with the binary values. Right? That's why this is called a transition table. Reduced transition table. Alright? And the column for the output will remain as it is. We are only concerned about my present state and the next state. So I have replaced A with 000 and B 001. Likewise for E 100. Alright? Now how to design this state reduction of my finite state machine. This is the procedure. For designing a synchronous sequential circuit. Now, first of all, what do you mean by synchronous circuit? Synchronous means my all the flip-flops are going to be triggered at the same time with the help of single clock. Right? In the asynchronous, my output of first flip-flop becomes the clock for the next flip-flop. Okay, if this flip-flop is going to be triggered, so we can't say at the same time my second flip-flop is also going to be triggered. Okay, so trigger all the flip-flop synchronously at the same time. We are going to apply clock to all the flip-flops same time. So this is called the synchronous circuit. Synchronous sequential circuit. Sequential means the examples are like flip-flop. All flip-flop that we have already discussed, that RS, JK, D, T, master slave JK flip-flop. Alright? So how to design, coming back to this designing procedure for the finite state machine of synchronous sequential circuit. The first step is, we are only concerned about whether we need to design a state machine for a synchronous vector, for bending machine. So based on the requirement, based on the specification of desired operation, we are deriving a state diagram of the circuit first. Okay? As we have seen that first of all we are designing a state diagram. From the state diagram, we will see if it is possible or not to reduce the number of states. Okay? If there are number of states are more, then we are going to reduce that state. Third step, we are assigning the binary values. Fourth state, we are obtaining its binary coded state table. Now what does it mean? From the state table, what we have done, in the present state column and the next state column, we have written its letter form. But in the transition table, we are writing like its binary assignment. So we have converted that letter, or you can say state table, into the transition table. So it is done over here. Okay. Fifth, we are choosing which type of letter we are going to use, like whether it is RS, D, T, or JK. In the last session, we have seen the Mealy state diagram, Mealy state diagram, analysis of Mealy and Mealy state machine using the D flip flop. So most of the time we are going to use the D flip flop only. Okay. Sixth step, we are deriving the simplified flip flop input equation and the output equation. Why? Because based on the input and output equation, we are able to draw its logical diagram, or you can say a digital circuit. Okay. So what these steps 4 through 7 will represents? It represents the exit algorithm, which is automated. So from state 4 to 7 is known as the synthesis of state machine. That is synthesis of synchronous sequential circuit. Alright. Now, let us take one example of designing a synchronous sequential circuit. We are going to detect the sequence of three or more consecutive ones straight of bits coming through the input line. That means, based on what is my input, whether it is 1 or 0. So now I am focusing on the, if the input is equal to continuous a string of 1, that is my area of interest. Okay, that I am only going to detect. If it is 0, it is going to be neglected. Okay, we are only concerned about my input is equal to consecutive sequence of 1s. Right? So we can come up with a state diagram of Moore model sequential circuit. Moore model means we are writing the output inside the circle, that means with the present state. Alright? See, this is the state diagram in which there are total 4 states S0, S1. S2 and S3, right? So based on these 4 states and what is my input, I am only concerned about my next state. I am not concerned about what is my output, right? Consider S0. If input is equals to 0, what is my next state? Same as the earlier, that is S0. If my present and next both are same, then I am going to detect this error in the same loop, in the same state. Okay? Moving forward, if input is equals to 1 for state 0, then only I am going to move forward to the state 1, that is S1. Why? Because we are concerned about the designing of sequence detector of 3 or more consecutive 1. Right now I am taking the example of 3 consecutive 1. Alright? If it is for state 1, if my input is equals to 0, we are not concerned. That means whether it can be in the same state or I can say my next state would be S0. You can take either of them. Okay? Now, if my next state is equals to 1, then only I am moving forward to the state that is S2. Alright? 4. And now I am in the state 2, that is S2. What is my output for that? The earlier S1, it was 0. For the input is equals to 1. Now, and I am in the state 2, that is S2. And if my input is equals to 1, then only I am going to move forward to the S3.